Is the current fear in the financial markets justified, and what is the best way to handle it and other market mood swings? Well, our first guest is an award-winning journalist who studies both market and investor behavior. He is Jason Zweig, senior writer for Money Magazine, recent editor of Benjamin Graham's classic, The Intelligent Investor, and the author of the just-published Your Money and Your Brain, How the New Science of Neuroeconomics Can Help Make You Rich. And our next guest has successfully invested through many market cycles. Hersh Cohen is senior portfolio manager and co-chief investment officer for Clearbridge Advisors. Since 1979, he has guided what is now called the Legg Mason Partners Appreciation Fund. The fund has been named to the Forbes Honor Roll 8 times for its long-term market-beating performance and value-oriented approach to growth stocks. And value is the name of the game for our third guest, who started his investment career managing hedge funds at his firm T2 Partners. In 2005, Whitney Tilson branched out and started his Tilson Focus Mutual Fund, one of the top-ranked funds in its category last year. He is also co-founder and co-editor of the newsletter Value Investor Insight. So welcome to all of you. It's been a very exciting week and day in the stock markets and the financial markets in general, which comes to you. Jason, I want to ask you all in the opening the same question, and that is, there's a lot of fear in the market, fear of recession, fear of, you know, liquidity crunch, credit tightening, job losses. You know, you can take your pick. So how fearful are each of you about the outlook for the markets and the economy right now? Jason?
Well, I don't know that I'm fearful about the outlook for the markets, Consuelo, so much as I'm worried that investors don't really understand their own fears. I think that's the biggest issue here. You know, the way the human brain works, it takes only 12 hundredths of a second. That's basically a third the length of the time it takes you to blink your eye for people to register fear, consciously or unconsciously. The sight, the sound, the smell, red colors, arrows pointing downward, stock tickers and charts going like this, people become fearful. And in the grip of fear, they cannot be rational. They cannot make a logical decision. And even unconscious fear can skew your judgment and lead you to do something rash that you would never do in a calm moment.
So is that something you're afraid that investors are going to do now? And are you seeing that in the markets right now?
I think that's exactly what we're seeing right now. We're seeing a stimulus overload, where people are staring at the computer screen all day long. People are watching financial television all day long, not just one show.
Right.
And all of those behaviors lead people to react.
And that's
a problem.
And react inappropriately.
That's correct. And that's true for professional investors as well as individual investors.
Well, we're facing two professional investors, so let's see how your emotions are holding up right now. How concerned are you, Hersh, about what's going on? What are you worried about?
I think you're a warrior. I think you have to be cautious. I always worry, but mm-hmm. I've been pretty bullish from the crash of the summer of 2002, really until year end of 2006, pretty constructive. But I think the housing situation is I didn't know when it would spread to the consumer. Looks like it might just be now doing that. On a shorter term basis, from a job point of view, from consumer cutting back,
right?
I don't know if there's going to be a recession or not, and I'm concerned about that. And I think the market is going to have trouble making headway until people figure out whether there's going to be a recession. Markets do well once they can understand if there's a recession and what the depth of it would be. And people haven't really talked about the probability of a recession. I'm not sure how you really avoid one with everything. So, I mean, I give the odds of greater than 50% that we have some downturn in the economy. How severe? I don't know.
Because of housing,
the consumer, energy prices.
Right.
And I'm really equally concerned about the kind of quality of trading that we've seen in the market, these huge intraday swings, not by individuals, but by professionals pressing a computer button. And I think, to me, that's a risky situation. So you look back in 1987, what happened. So, I'm nervous.
Right.
Yeah.
Whitney?
Sure. Well, your question presumes there's a lot of fear out there. And frankly, I'm not seeing tremendous amounts of fear in the stock market. There's a real disconnect between the stock and the bond market. The bond markets are still not quite as seized up as they were a few weeks ago, but in your opening credits there, it talked about how banks are reluctant to lend to one another, and that's very telling because they're looking at their own books and seeing trillions of dollars of derivatives that they don't really know what they own, and they know that all their counterparties have the same book of business, so they're reluctant to lend to each other and more willing to lend to businesses with real cash flows out there. That's not as seized up. So I think there could be some real bombs there in the financial system where enormous leverage has built up in the system, and we're starting to see some unwinding there. So as far as the stock market goes, though, we're not seeing anything like what we saw in late 2002, early 2003, and that's where value guys like us really make money. When there's really blood in the streets and major indices are down 20% or more, we're not seeing anything like that at this point. So we're being very cautious, waiting for that scenario perhaps to unfold. I'm not exactly predicting it,
right,
but the odds of that kind of scenario have gone up a lot just in the past couple of months, and so we've got a lot of dry powder, have sold any low conviction ideas, concentrate our portfolio in just a dozen high conviction ideas.
You don't have those pockets of huge overvaluation that you had in 99.
Right.
I mean, I think that's the difference. You don't really have an expensive market. I don't know what the P's. So that's part of the problem is what the P's will be next year is going to be a function of whether we do, the economy does roll over or not. So I think that's an unknown that the market has to deal with. I don't know how you feel about that. But in terms of collapse because of overvaluation, that's a different story.